Every morning, I wake up, I go through my day doing the regular human stuff, eating, drinking, seeing, and interacting. I see an ocean of people, all similar in how they surrender to the world put in front of their eyes, all walking the fine line between what's asked of them by society and the fulfillment of their own personal fantasy. Both of these sides of their lives, completely engrossed by the nature of the world they find themselves in. A friend of mine wants to be a doctor, another wants to be an architect, another a singer, a photographer, all of which are rather human aspirations, I find. Nothing that ever wanders out of the known, we're all stuck in society. Even those who aspire to go against society and popular culture never stray too far. We're all stuck in reality, and it never seems to cross our mind how absurd it is. It crosses mine, though. Every now and then, I'll be thinking about color and the physics of it. Well, at least the little bit that I do know. I'll think about how color is pretty much an illusion. The only real thing about light is the wavelength of energy hitting your eye. The part where you notice, ah yes, this thing is red, happens entirely inside your mind. Light is real. Color is the illusion. My train of thought will then broaden a bit to think about all senses, and how every single one is fake. They are all ways for your brain to apprehend the outside world, but in no way are they giving you the full story of what's out there. Sound doesn't exist more than color does. Pressure waves through air are not some cosmically audible phenomenon. Sound is just another bias of being alive, of individuality. In fact, individuality isn't even real. The ego is the process that happens in your mind that gives you the concept of self, lets you know that you are you, that you are an individual, separate from your surroundings. With this going on in your mind, you are oblivious to the fact that what makes you up is the very same rock, dirt, and water that makes up the pen you write with and the car you drive. After having reflected upon this for a little while, I'll usually say something along the lines of, "Oh yeah, I forgot that life is a trance. Nothing of what we experience about the universe is real. Nothing is objective. In fact, even just the idea of being a separate entity whose mind is his own is all part of the trance, the illusion of perception which stands between mind and reality. It's frustrating in a way for me who seeks truth. I'm so tantalizingly close. I am only one consciousness away from all the truth the universe has to give us, and I seem to get a bit closer every time I think about it. But because I'm a human, I get lost in the trance of life again and again. Resume normal life, resume a society built around what we perceive to be true, resume thinking what doesn't matter does, and that the world I see around me is as true as it gets. It's not. Life is a dream. A figurative retelling of things that are real through images that are not. We see, we hear, feel, and think, but none of these processes actually let the objective reality into our minds. You then have to wonder, why is it that we are not allowed to watch the universe as it really is? What would such a thing even feel like? Well, we try it out every night between our dreams. Think about what it feels like to sleep. A gap in consciousness, void of senses or thought. You wake up each morning unaware of what happened during that time. That's what snapping out of the dream of life would feel like. Nothing. That's the tragic truth about objective reality. We can't ever hope to know it, because knowing anything means being conscious, and being conscious means experiencing this filtered version of reality. We're in a cosmic trance from beginning to end. Everything you may ever hope to touch, taste, see, is only a proxy of what it really is. The only way anyone could possibly hope to get closer to objective truth is through thought. If you realize that life is a trance, you are then rerouting understanding to something more fundamental, because you understand that you cannot understand. At the end of the day, we are all just chunks of the universe, pieces of rock, dirt, and water that weren't experiencing anything, but at some point got comfortable in the form of a human and fell asleep and dreamt. I had a dream, it says now. I dreamt wavelength was color, and pressure was sound, and meaning meant something. I looked for it for a whole lifetime, but never found it. I searched for understanding, but never understood. I looked for love, convinced I knew what it was. I was passionate and grateful some days. Others, I was mean and scornful. I was able to voice my opinion just as much as I could keep it for myself. And myself was a notion that was just as real as the love I felt when I saw another sleeping rock. I saw plenty. One wanted to be a doctor, another wanted to be an architect. They all had their own paths to follow, almost as if unaware that they would eventually wake up. And that cosmic morning, the universe sees its dream, just as absurd as anyone does, after a night of sleep.